romance fashion director at Saks Fifth Avenue. Sounds like an absolute dream job, is it?
It is a dream job. I get that a lot. People do say to me, that is when you're in the fashion industry, that is the job that everybody wants. Yeah. And I've been
you
at
have
it for 4 years now. I've been doing this, and it's been a wonderful experience.
How can I picture a typical day?
Well, you can't, because every day is different. I don't get to my office until probably 5 o'clock, maybe 6 o'clock at night, because we're in the market, we're working with the designers, we're working at the showrooms, we're in meetings. So I'm out in the city. I go into so many of these showrooms across the city that every day is different. I work from suits to socks to sandals to belts. I mean, everything I see.
So tell me about the schedule during Fashion Week.
Well, Fashion Week, I do London Fashion Week, I do Milan Fashion Week, I do Paris Fashion Week, I do New York Fashion Week, and each city is very different.
Which one's your favorite?
Which one is my favorite? Paris.
Okay, why?
Paris. Well, do you want to know the truth?
Yes, of course I want.
The truth is because in Paris, my whole team goes back to New York City, and it's just me in Paris on my own. So it's a lot more fun. I have more flexibility and more freedom. Plus, the fashion there is more avant-garde and more interesting.
Okay. So what about New York?
So New York Fashion Week is predominantly women's. So for men's, it's not as important. We see a lot more new, emerging, and upcoming designers in New York. We don't see the big brands. We see most of the big brands in Europe.
Okay, is there one special designer who consistently surprises you?
I am a big fan of Michael Bastian. I am a big fan of Rag & Bone. I love Y3. I think they do some of the best shows in New York Fashion Week. And then Marc by Marc Jacobs. We're going to see Marc by Marc in a few minutes, and that's another highlight for me.
Okay. I think I'm going with you.
Please, come with me.
Okay.
I can usually get people in and I can squeeze them right next to me, so you're welcome to come.
What's happening after a show? What do you do if you like an outfit?
Well, after the show, I will often go behind the stage and give the designer a big hug and a big kiss. Usually that's their time to talk to the press, so I don't want to take up too much of their time, but I want to at least go back and congratulate them.
Do you have a style icon?
Right now I'm liking Ryan Gosling. I think he's got a lot of style, he's got a great presence. Colin Firth also, I think since he's been working with Tom Ford, he's got incredible style. So one sort of a younger look and one for a more mature look. I like both of them, good examples.
How would you describe your personal style?
You know, I'm going to say something which I hate, but I'm going to say it anyways. I would say classic with a twist. I think it's a term that's overused, basically. I hear it all the time. But I think in reality, it does kind of describe my style. I do tend to like the more classic things, but I like to put my own twist on my own spin on them.
Tell me about your favorite New York hotspot.
My favorite New York hotspot right now is a place called Bathtub Gin. It reminds me of a speakeasy during the Prohibition era in the 20s, you know, when you weren't allowed to drink alcohol, they would have these hidden clubs. Mm-hmm. So when you walk past it, it looks like a small coffee shop from the street. But when you walk in and you press the back wall, it opens up into this fantastic bar and club.